I have some black trumpet mushrooms. This mushroom is normally a very small mushroom. These are pretty average size. Some smaller ones here. This one there. These are often called the black chanterelle. I'm going to pull it up. They're not really a true chanterelle, and there is a variety of black trumpet species. I think there's about four that I've read about, and I don't know them well enough to know exactly which one this is, but they are all very good edible mushrooms. They have a very strong flavor for being such a small, delicate mushroom. They're very good to use in gravies and soups and things like that. If you cook them, just saute them by themselves, you want to be careful and not overcook them. The first time I found a bunch of these, I overcooked them and it really kind of ruined them. But they're so small, they cook very quickly. But they tend to go in mossy areas like this. Several little patches of moss right here. I've been picking some already that are a little oranger on top. Now these, they're called black trumpets. Sometimes they can be completely black. Sometimes more of a brown, dark brown color like this. Sometimes gray. But sometimes they can be even lighter, like tending toward a little bit of an orange color like that. But they are completely hollow. I don't know if that'll come through. I cut the bottom off of this one. But you can see light through the other side. And so a lot of times they can tend to have little bugs and critters hiding in them. So when you clean them, you want to check for that for sure. Some people use them to flavor wine. I've never had that before, but they say it adds a nice, almost like a fruity flavor. I got a couple here. They're much lighter. It could be because they're older. I'm not really getting mildewy or rotten yet, but the flavor might not be as good. There's a couple little ones there. Over here I saw, I'm gonna have to scan the ground very carefully, but I saw a very, very large one over here. And as they get much bigger, of course they tend to spread apart a little more at the top and sort of break or rip apart, but this is still very, feels very good and fresh. So that's gonna be a nice one for eating. Right over there in that little mossy area is where I was finding those trumpets. Came over here to check out these big boletes. Probably the bitter bolete, but I don't know that for sure. But anyway, right around these boletes, more trumpets. Many times, in fact, usually, once you find some, if you start looking around, you'll find a lot more because they tend to grow in large scattered groups. Some nice ones there. I'm gonna be here picking a while. Boy, I tell you, I'm in a very mushroomy section of the forest right here. And the ground is just littered with lacterious species, boletes, chanterelles, cinnabars. But the further I walk, I see more and more and more black trumpets too. You just gotta look a lot closer for them. Just got a large area of them right here. They're just all over the place. I don't know how, if you can see them or if they just look like leaves on the camera, but nice large area. Let's get down on the ground level a little more. Maybe you can see them a little better. Some of them are very nice size as well. Now the trumpets really don't have any gills, and really not any ridges to speak of like the chanterelles do. They get pretty wrinkly on the underside a lot of times. Can I guess kind of look like some ridges on the bottom, and some of them will have really faint ridges, but for the most part they're just smooth but wrinkly underneath. Just thought I would document these. This is called the Devil's Urn mushroom. From what I understand, they are not really edible, but not really poisonous. Just not any good to eat. But they kind of resemble the black trumpets a little bit. If you don't really know what a black trumpet looks like, they could be mistaken for them until you've seen enough of them. But I just thought I'd mention that. Some more of the Devil's Urn mushroom. Okay, I'm standing in, I don't know if you can tell, but I'm standing in what's known as a wash. It's a place between two higher points on either side, on the side of a hill, where when you get excessive rain, the water runs down and sort of washes out. You know, it'll many times be sort of a clean path. Sometimes like this, it's kind of strewn with leaves and stuff. But this is where the water rushes down the side of the hill when we get a whole lot of rain. And black trumpets really like to grow along the side of a wash. Like right there. I've got a whole little cluster of them. If I look right up here, one right there. You can tell they are so hard to see. It's actually a couple large ones right there. And when they're this brown color, they just blend right in with the leaves. And I've heard it said that looking for black trumpets is kind of like looking for holes in the ground. A lot of mushrooms like the chanterelles and the boletes and mushrooms that just stand out, you can, as you're walking through the woods, just kind of scan and look for the color, look for the profile of them standing up. Well, black trumpets, you almost got to look straight down when you're looking for them. So it really helps to know the type of area to look in. Alongside washes, where the water runs down the side of a mountain, is a good one. Like I mentioned before, mossy areas tend to really hold moisture, and that's what they like, so those are good areas to look for. And when you find yourself there, just stare straight down at your feet. Just look, walk slowly, look really closely for those open holes. So I've dehydrated several trays of these trumpets, and they are actually a very, very good mushroom for dehydrating and rehydrating. They're so thin it doesn't take long. They just dehydrate to a crisp. And as you can see, many of the really small ones just almost go down to nothing. But they're great for rehydrating, to put into sauces or soups, gravies, things like that. They add a great flavor. If you've never found these before or had them, I'd recommend you do your best to find some. They're a very difficult one to find, but very rewarding, very tasty, very fun to find and to cook with. Hi. You want to try some black trumpets?
Of course! I want those.
Yep. I think.
Sort of good.
Sort of good?
Yeah.
Well, you sort of liked them the other night when we had them. These are actually rehydrated. We dried them out and then we tried rehydrating them. I think they'd be pretty good, but then maybe the flavor was just a little bit better when they were fresh. But we're still pretty happy with them, huh?
Yeah.
All right, those are the Black Trumpets. Thanks for watching.